see you there. I was just writing an article for the New York World newspaper. My name is Elizabeth Jane Cochran, better known as Nellie Bly. I am known for being one of the first female reporters, my famous trip around the world, as well as my inventions and patents. I was born in 1864 in Cochran's Mills, Pennsylvania. I was one of 15 children. It was a very full house. When I was 16, we moved to Pittsburgh, where I started working at a boarding house. One day, I saw an article in the Pittsburgh Dispatch newspaper saying women shouldn't work. They should just stay home, clean, cook, and take care of their children. The article described working women as a monstrosity. I thought the article was absolutely wrong, so I wrote a letter to the Pittsburgh Dispatch newspaper saying women should be able to work. When the Pittsburgh Dispatch got my letter, they asked if I could come and show myself in the office. I went there and almost immediately got hired as a reporter because I was such a good writer. When I started working for the newspaper, the editor offered me a pen name, Nellie Bly. I wrote many articles with subjects such as women's work and divorce. In 1887, I moved to New York City where I started working for the New York World newspaper. During my first year at the New York World, I went undercover in an insane asylum on Blackwell's Island. I was planning to act insane so I could write about the treatment of the patients. This was a very unusual thing for a woman to do in the 1800s. The insane asylum was horrible. The doctors and nurses treated the patients terribly. After 10 days, the New York World newspaper came to save me from the insane asylum. Afterwards, I wrote articles about my experience. But people wanted more information, so I wrote and published a book called 10 Days in a Madhouse. Because of my articles, city officials changed the way the patients were treated at the asylum. In 1888, I suggested to my editor that I should take a trip around the world in less than 80 days. I was inspired to do this by the book Around the World in 80 Days by Jules Verne. It took some convincing because nobody thought I could do it, but I finally left in 1889 with one small tote, a bag around my neck where I kept my money, and hope, worry, and bravery mixed into one emotion. I ran into several troubles along the way and got delayed a lot. About halfway through the trip, I found out I had competition. A woman named Elizabeth Bislam was racing against me. This was a race the whole nation was watching. I had many adventures on my many stops. In Singapore, I even adopted a pet monkey named McGinty as a travel companion. When I got back to Jersey City, I took a deep breath and stepped onto the platform. I made around the world in 72 days, 6 hours, 11 minutes, and 14 seconds. I had set a world record and beat Elizabeth Bislam. 4 years later, I married Robert Seaman, who is the owner of the Ironclad Manufacturing Company. In 1902, I invented stackable garbage cans, a new design of a milk can, and the 55-gallon oil drum. My husband, Robert, died in 1904. That same year, I became president of the company. Sadly, the company went bankrupt in 1914 when the employees were stealing from it. Later that year, while traveling in Austria, World War I broke out. I decided to return to journalism so I could write about the war from the front lines. When I got back home to New York City, I started working for the New York Evening Journal. My main focus of writing was abandoned children. Sadly, I died in 1922 of pneumonia when I was 57 in New York City. In my life, I was a famous female reporter. I went around the world in 72 days. I invented and patented several objects. And I was a war reporter from the front lines of World War I. I did all this as a woman where other women were not. In 1998, I was inducted into the Women's Hall of Fame. I'll forever be known as the daring and brave Nellie Bly.